Yeah, what's up guys, and welcome back to the channel. Yeah, so today's video, the plan and the dimension for this build that we make for this outdoor patio chair. So yep, since I don't really have a concrete plan for this build, but it's a very easy construction, and all the measurement that I did, I just based on the cushion for the chair of every client that I have. And yep, they always give me the dimension of their cushion, and then I'm just gonna go from there. But for this build that I did, I just make this one from one of my clients, because she has a like 25 by 24 a cushion, the foam for the chair. So I just went it from there. So what I did in here is, like, this is just a very easy, there's so much measurement that we did in here. So for this construction, what I did in here, these two pieces in here, this bottom piece and the top piece, are just the same measurement. So that is a 31 and a 3/4 for this both. So what I did is just that you can just cut 4 pieces for one chair, or if you want like 2, you can cut 8 of this, 31 and 3/4, I mean. Yeah, this is 31 and 3/4, yep. So that's all pretty basic. And yep, of course, and this one for the height of this, like you can just work whatever height you want. But for this build, so for the angle that I did, I choose the 15 degrees miter. I miter this leg in here, this leg, I miter it like 15 degrees over here. So the same thing over here, so that these two will meet, and they closes the gap. So make it sure that when you slide your top piece, make it sure that this one will closes here, and the gap, and there's no gap over here. Because once you glue that one, because that would give a lot of strength for the build that you did. So yeah, it's pretty much easy. You got two the same sizes, the bottom and the top piece. So yeah, and for the back rest or back receiver, this structure in here, this piece of wood in here. So the measurement of that, it's 24 inches. The same thing for the pieces, it's the same size for the pieces that we gonna put it here on the face, on the face of this chair. And also the same thing here at the top, where you can sit your butt in here, or call it butt, whatever it calls. But yep, so you can always, like, you know, like I have 24 inches, 31 and 3/4, sorry, for the main structure of this chair. So right, and for this over here, this inside piece where this piece will sit, this I always like rely on how many pieces that I'm gonna put it here, so that we'll make it sure that you won't cut a small piece right in the last piece that you're gonna put here in this chair, right? So that's how we build this chair. And of course, we have to make sure that everything is flush before I install this one. Before I install this piece, I make sure that this will be flush over here. Like, you could always work with it, like, you know, like if you want like a little bit low for this piece, you can put this one a little bit low. But if you want to be flush all the way here, then you can just clamp a piece over here and then install this bottom piece where this thing will rest, right? So that's how easy it is. And just like what I mentioned, is everything actually, if you're just gonna pocket hole this thing over here, this is not really necessary in here, because that, you know, but just for the peace of mind, like, you could always put this one in here just to give more strength to your project, which is really good. So yeah, that's how we measure this one. That's how we, I don't really have a concrete plan for this project. So what I did here is, like, you know, everything is just, like, you know, I tried to figure it out, everything just in the back of my brain. That's the easy way where I build this up. And yep, for the height of this is just I believe this is 16 inches, I mean like like the whole thing here, from the top here all the way here, is 16 inches. Yeah, I believe it's 16 inches. Yeah, it is. It is 16. So, yeah, for this one, as I gotta say it again, this is a 15 degrees angle over here. I might throw it 15 degrees, and the rest of it are all the same. So if you cut 15 degrees over here, you can taper the same thing over here for 15 degrees. And so that you have a square thing over here for this detail over here, you can also cut, you can also miter here 15 degrees so that when you put the chair all the way or thing like this, you can see this one is square over here. And you can, if you don't want this detail in here, you can just cut all the way here and that's pretty square. Because you just use a one angle, like a 15 degrees angle. So, yep. And for this thing over here, where I taper this one, you can just like, you know, like the same thing what I did in here. Like I just eyeball everything in this thing, where my back could, or you know, like enough for the back to rest, like in a relaxed position, which is really good. So, yep, that's how we did this one. It's only two measurements we did. This is a 31 3/4, the bottom and the top piece, and this is 24 inches. The same thing, the piece on our, the whole thing where we're gonna sit, and the back receiver. So that's all we did here in this construction. But I don't really have a concrete plan, but I'm gonna make a video. How did I plan this one? It's pretty nice and easy. Easy build for the whole thing. And yep, the key here so that we have a pretty square build and everything will be exactly the same. I have to measure it precisely, because otherwise, like you know, like the chair doesn't sometimes, like you know, the other leg is like it's like a shorter and longer, and then a little bit high. So what we're gonna do now is we have to assemble this one, and yep, the other piece that I did yesterday, since yep, that was the two pieces that I just did it, stain it, and deliver it to the customer. So yep, and also thank you for leaving a comment down in the comment section, so that I could improve this build, or whatever that I could change, whatever that we need to change in this build. And I got one. Yeah, right, so already start assembling this one. So what we're gonna do here, because we don't have extra hand to hold all this piece, so we always need a clamp. Like if you're working alone with this, like a clamp, like you know, whatever those are available in, you know, some big box store that is cheaper, like you know, you could always purchase the one, invest on that, like you know, like investing for a tool, like for a DIYer like me, like you know, like everyone else, like you could do a lot of things after your project. So your first project, your second project done, you can do a lot of things. Like, you know, when I started all my DIY stuff here, like just like this deck, I did this myself. Like, I was just investing in my tools before. So, yep. So, whatever you see here from my deck, all my patio, like I did it, my shed. So, it was just, I just starting investing my tools when I start my first project. My very first project is this, my deck. So I invested in my tools, and then right after that, then I made a lot of things. So that's easy. So yep, without further ado, we're gonna proceed and assemble this one. So we're just gonna go clamp it. Just like what I said, this is all a pocket hole joinery. So it's not a problem of joining this one, as long as you have all the perfect square cut. So it should be good. So all right, let's screw this in. So all right, we already did let this base for this chair. So So what we're gonna do now is just gonna lay all those stuff in here for your bath. Now it's like, you know, like all you're gonna do is just, sorry, because they all have the same sizes in here and that. So that's pretty easy. So just like what I mentioned before, this is only two sizes that I did for the main structure. This is the top and the bottom are all the same size. And this part in here, with the rest of it, it's all the same size. And the same thing as this back receiver structure in here. So the same thing, that's all the same size from this. This one is the same size with this. So the same length, what I mean, sorry. So, yep, and I just taper it so that it gives a little bit of a detailed look, like a good look for the chair that we make. So it's pretty much easy. So, yep, I just got a comment that asking for the plan and the dimension of this whole construction. So, like, honestly, like, I don't have this a concrete plan for this. Everything, we're just like, you know, just I just rely on whatever the available cushion that my client have. Like, you know, you can put a cushion on top of this. So whatever they have, so I just go on from that sizes. So they said they have 25 by 25, so I can just adjust this length in here. So that's all we need. And if ever they wanna have a longer backrest, so we can just adjust this one as well a little bit back. So that's how we're gonna work for this. But yep, since he requested for the plan and dimension, I will be making a video for that, like a specific video for the construction of this for the plan and dimension of, like, we're just gonna make it standard dimension for this. So it's gonna be like 24 by 24. So I'm gonna make a sketch for that, or we'll say a project plan. So you can just hit that subscribe button and that notification bell as well, so that you can get into that upcoming video that we're gonna make. Right, so we'll just go ahead and finish this up. Yeah, right, so the very first piece that we're gonna put it here, we're gonna start here at the back. I'm gonna show you. We're gonna start it here, and we're gonna work out all the way over here, so that we can have a pretty square here, both sides, this side, and this side as well. So we're gonna work out from here all the way over here. So yep, just like what I said, like, we need an extra hand in here, and I got this clamp. So yep, I'm pretty good working alone with this stuff, and you as well, you could do that as well. So all right, so go ahead and screw this in. We'll be right back.